As you can see, that spool there is plenty packed tight enough, so I'm just going to cut that off and then I'm going to get into time my double. Okay, I swing the rod around in the holder, I pull out. Now, reasonably long double. If you're fishing IGFA, of course you've got to really measure your double length. I'm not particularly fussed about all of that. I don't really care if a bunch of old dudes in Florida want to ratify my fish or not. I just want to catch them. So, to catch fish, you need a good knot. So, I've got probably about 2 meters of doubled over line there. If you come in and have a look closely here, you'll see just how I'm going to tie it. Now, the first thing we want to make sure is we've got a lot of tension, so it does need to be in a rod holder. Now, if you're tying a plait and your fingers aren't sore, well, you're probably not tying it tight enough. So we pull that tight and we're simply doubling the line over, putting it into the middle, and now we've got three strands. And we're just going to plait those three strands, just like you'd plait your mum's hair. I hope you don't know, I don't plait my mum's hair. Oh, that was a joke again, sorry. So we're just keeping it nice and tight, and I'm pinching down every time just to not let, make sure nothing slips, keeping all that tension. Okay, so now I've plaited about 3 inches or 75 mil there, maybe a little bit more, and I've kept that tight. And once I'm satisfied that that's enough for a working plait for me, I'm gonna continue plaiting for about another inch or 25 mils. Except now, as you can see, I'm plaiting much looser. I've let the tension come off. We just finished this loose section off with the tag end in the middle. And we just bring it up through the middle. So here's my tag end. Here's my double out here. And just to secure that, the reason I've threaded this last bit loosely is because I'm going to weave this tag end back up through this loose part of the plait. So I don't go through the first plait, I come up to the second one and I just poke that end through and I pull it tight. I can relax now, that's not going to come undone. And just to finish it off nicely, I'm just going to weave back and forth through this loose section of the plait. I'm back to the tight section now. I trim it off, I just leave just a wee bit of tag end. That there, your finished plait, if I let the tension off, yep, should get a curve in it, and that's from the tension. Now, not only does this give me, well, they say pretty much 100% line strength, you've got a nice shock absorber. You can see there, that's like a spring in the system. So, I'm going to wind that knot up onto the reel, keep everything nice and tight, make sure I've got a nice, even amount of weight on my double before I attach my swivel.